Thanks for watching. I'm meteorologist Jacqueline Thomas. After a beautiful showing of the Northern Lights Friday night, there is another chance to catch a glimpse out there tonight. There's still this very, very strong geomagnetic storm happening. In fact, the strongest solar storm that we've really seen in the last 20 years or so. And the forecast still allows for New Hampshire to be in that view line of the Northern Lights. When it comes to how strong the aurora has to be in order to actually see an aurora here in New Hampshire, you want to have that KP index around 7, 8, or even 9. And that's what we're looking at as we head through the night tonight. We're looking at another potentially severe solar storm expected as we see these disturbances in the magnetic field. And yeah, really incredible pictures have been coming in from last night. So if you have a chance to try to catch a glimpse tonight, highly recommended, because it just really is incredible what you're able to capture. So if you want to try to catch a glimpse, well, you're going to have to battle some clouds, because we are going to see clouds thickening up as the night goes on. The best chance to see the Northern Lights tonight is going to be between that 10 o'clock midnight time frame. After midnight, those clouds quickly thicken up. Your best chance during the overnight hours to see anything will be as you head far north in the state, where you'll likely have a clearer sky. So if you're trying to see the Northern Lights, it will be possible, but it'll be best seen away from city lights. When you get all that light pollution, even street lights, it can make it a little harder to actually see. And a lot of the photos that you're seeing being spread around from this Northern Lights phenomenon is not actually what people are seeing with their naked eye. If you step outside, you might notice a subtle little glow. It might seem like subtle little clouds in the sky almost, but it really is the aurora. And when you take a photo with a slow shutter speed camera, it allows for the exposure of more light to come in, and it really can show you those vibrant colors in the sky. So you want to look to the north and a little bit closer to the horizon if possible to really have your best bet. And you're going to have to battle some clouds, so try to find a clear spot in the sky. Look for little stars. If you see stars, and there's a good chance that you could also catch a glimpse of the aurora.